Well, I'm back. I don't know how else to say it. Super excited for today's video, guys. I want to explain to you where I've been, what the heck I've been doing. It's been months since I've been shooting YouTube videos. Haven't had a chance to do an update video. In today's video, we're going to discuss where I've been, what I've been doing, and what's to come for the channel.
Do you want to win cash for watching Patrick's videos? If so, be sure to watch the whole video, leave a like, and comment the hidden message. Now, let's get right into the video.
Traders, investors, moneymakers, it's Patrick, and I'm so excited to be back with you today in today's video from the brand new studio. How about it? So we are now finally, I've been telling you guys, I've been waiting for this day for a long time. I'm already hitting the mic. It's shaking. I'm not even really done with it. I'm trying to figure out everything, but I am super excited for today's video to discuss this behind me, this set. We've got fancy books for no reason. Do I read these? No, they're blank books with black covers. We've got a monitor where I can see myself over here. We've got multiple TVs behind me. I've got my laptop here, which is actually being used. It's not just a place. We've got a brand new big solid desk. So much good stuff, but that's really beside the point. I just want to talk about where I've been, what I've been doing. I'm shooting this video early March of 2021, and I haven't put out a video since December of 2020. And really, late in 2020, I wasn't shooting many videos, and I want to explain in today's video where I've been. So let's just hop right into it. A couple different things come to mind just to kind of get you on this journey. Last September, as interest rates continued to get lower and lower, the idea of purchasing a home for me to actually live in, instead of, as some of you guys knew, I was renting a great apartment, a crazy view, super high up. It was an amazing apartment in the Biltmore area in Phoenix, if you're familiar with the area. And as interest rates started to get lower, I just began to really keep my eye out for a great place to live. Not only a great place to live, but an investment for the future, something that would be rentable for the future or in a great area, up and coming, great appreciation, those sort of things. And in September, I ended up finding this property I'm now sitting in, this home. And right now we're sitting in my studio, and we are down in the lower part of the house. It's three floors, it's real big townhome, beautiful area, Scottsdale, Arizona, up and coming, as well as amazing amenities, gym, pool, security, all that good stuff. And I'm super excited to be here. But that's the first thing, guys. So in September, I put down an offer on this home. I actually got accepted. Funny part was I had four other offers ahead of me, above me as well, above asking price. And I was able to come in below asking price because the owners couldn't move out until December. And so I put in that offer and it got under contract in September and they couldn't move out till December. And so that gap was the only reason I was able to get such a great deal on this property. Super excited about this property here. And this is now where my studio is going to be. I'm able to shoot videos. I'm able to do live broadcasts, potentially podcasts. I don't know. What do you think? It looks like a podcast studio. I mean, some cool stuff. And overall, it's a great investment as well, because these units are renting right now. This exact unit right next door is renting for $3,300 a month. Well above what my mortgage is. And so I know I can cash flow this. It's already appreciated potentially $50,000 since I purchased it, because of a recent close actually on that exact rental property. A person purchased it and then rented it immediately. So it was like a double whammy. It was like an identical property, but it was already rented out. So I got a comp on there and the sale comp. Super excited about that. So that's the first thing. I got a new, new place. And obviously getting a new place entails moving everything. And when I say everything, I mean everything. You don't realize how much stuff you have until you move. And once you move, you don't realize how long it takes to set up your life again. You know, I've got my computer on the other side of my office over there. I've got a studio on this side. It takes some time to get these sort of things set up. So there's that. What else has happened? Just a brief update on some other things, videos you may be looking forward to. First and foremost, DeLorean has exploded globally. Thousands of users now. And we've added a new feature called DeLorean Hyperdrive. It is a 5-minute super simple scalping method to be used not only in options, but in Forex trading for our clients. And that is an absolute hit, bigger than I probably could ever anticipated. And we added that on for free for our subscribers. Nothing that we were charging extra for, but rather just something saying, here you go. It's no different than regular DeLorean, other than it scans 5-minute time frames instead of 15-minute time frames, and it's giving them more options in the market. Some are using it for Forex, some are using it for options, some of are using it for both, and they're having an absolute blast doing it, making some great income, and I'm super excited about that. And there's going to be a ton of videos about DeLorean, Hyperdrive, Shadow, what's to come, future training videos, updates, market ideas, sequence trades, all sorts of stuff on the channel this year. So rest assured, for Forex traders listening to this, you're going to get all that super good stuff. And by the way, if you're not already subscribed, I already said this at the beginning, you need to subscribe because of how many videos I'm about to put out. Guys, I am in a YouTube studio now, and I can go. I have a stream deck right here. You guys probably can't see it. It's super cool. With one button, I'm recording. With one button, I can change scenes. I could go to my computer. I could go to my phone screen. With one button, I can stop recording, and I have the audio already linked. From a camera, not a webcam. This is important for speed. If something is on that TV that's important that needs to be talked about, I can get it done. And I want to say shout out to Meet Kevin. Everybody knows him. His financial channel has blown up because I actually purchased his course teaching how he does what he does studio-wise to get videos out fast. He's able to produce videos on brand new, just released news topics that he's just reading now, hit the record button, have a video out within 20 minutes. That's important for up-to-date news. So that's that with Forex and this update. A little more updates, other investments some of you guys have kept track of for me. Now, the real estate flip has been a little slower than we anticipated. The only reason I haven't made another video is, frankly, we haven't really done much more. We do have exterior demo permits, but the overall permit on the new plans have not been accepted yet, but they are very close, probably within this month of March. So with that said, the moment that that happens, we'll be able to start making new YouTube content. And that project is still projected to be done by the end of 2021, at least finish. Will it be sold by the end of 2021? I can only cross my fingers because that's when I get my money back out of the deal. But that is going to be some fun YouTube content for you guys as well. Finally, I also have a series that I will continue on Amazon automation. In the beginning of the pandemic last year, I think it was the last time I shot a video, and I haven't had a chance to shoot another one big time showing everything. We had $50,000 day in March when the pandemic hit. Unfortunately, I ran out of credit at that time and I shut my store off, but it was a godsend that I did, because everything that I was selling started to go out of stock from the drop shipping supplier, which I've told you guys we were using Walmart. And luckily, I kind of weaseled my way out of that, meaning we got to get any sale that we had, we got closed, we got refunds sent to customers, those sort of things. But then I was able to really sit down because of that and say, is this what I want to start battling? The more sales I get, the more stressed I am, the higher risk I am of being suspended. And I sat down with my team, some of my friends, some people that have even more experience in Amazon, and we discussed at length if I should continue to do drop shipping, or if I should just pivot that store into something else, or should I start a brand new store? What should I do? And what I ended up doing is actually getting a second store on top of the first store, and I'm actually transitioning both into FBA, still doing Amazon automation, but we just tweaked it a little bit. So instead of drop shipping, we're buying inventory ahead of time. And I'm happy to tell you that we have already completed January for a brand spanking new store, 47% margin. We'll talk about that later. Crazy. And February, I don't know what the margins are yet because we haven't reconciled the numbers from a refund standpoint and return, all that sort of stuff. Once that's in, we'll be able to do it there. But I'll start making you videos later in March on the January numbers for that FBA and February numbers for a clean slate. I'll also give you an update video on the previous store for what 2020 ended up doing. I mean, even though I ended in March and I took April, May, June, July, and August really to think, and then that's when I made the decision in the fall to start that FBA store, and it took forever to get a brand new store up, more paperwork, business partners, all that stuff. But I still ended up doing like $300,000 in sales in just those 3 months on that old store in 2020. So I was still blazing fast. Really good results there. So I think that probably synopsizes where I'm at. I don't have a heck of a lot other things going on other than I'm wanting to put more content out. So in the comment section below, whatever you want, you let me know. I'm really excited to be here. Number two, DeLorean, crazy live rooms, great experience for our customers. We've been making really great strides in our portfolios just in 2021 alone. new additions for Hyperdrive, things like that. Of course, real estate, I updated you on where that sits, and pretty soon I think that's going to ramp up super fast, and we'll get a ton of videos out this year and complete the project and see overall what the return was on my investment, if any, we hope. And then Amazon, obviously transitioning and being nimble in my way. I've been doing that since 2018. We're now in 2021, being able to say, okay, I think I know where the future is headed. I think I know that I don't want to be in that risky space of drop shipping. I think I'm going to go to FBA. So that's literally where we are at. You are now caught up to speed. We're in the studio. I'm giddy if you can't tell. I am super excited that you're here, guys. And genuinely, if you're watching these videos, thank you. Because what I'm trying to do is provide you useful content, things that you can use, whether you use it all, a little, some, inspiration, education, whatever it is, mindset. I don't know what it is that you take from me. Use some of it. Heck, you might say, I want to start a YouTube channel and you're copying this. I don't care what you do. If you get some value, let me know by clicking that like button in the description, okay? So with that said, I will see you guys very soon on the next video in 2021 in the new studio. We can't get better, any better than this. So thank you guys so much for watching this through. I'll see you guys soon, and God bless.